Welcome to Adult Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a big challenge. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. The Reflection Bridge. Clara's Voyage in the Heart of Lumina. Chapter 1. The Preparation. The moon was poised high in the night sky, a radiant silvery orb, but its shimmer was sporadically dimmed by the thick, velvety clouds. They drifted lazily, occasionally revealing glimpses of the glinting stars beyond. The weather forecast had hinted at a thunderstorm, and the atmosphere bore testament to the prediction. On the 12th floor of an aging apartment building, Clara's room glowed with a warm, amber light. The room was a medley of old and new. Vintage trinkets lined wooden shelves, photographs of fond memories peppered the walls, and a state-of-the-art sound system played soft, ambient music that harmonized with the occasional rustling of leaves outside. Her cozy room smelled of lavender and chamomile. An ornate kettle sat bubbling on a modern induction stove, the steam dancing in the air. Clara busied herself with preparing a cup of her favorite herbal tea. It was her grandmother's recipe, a blend of dried herbs that Clara believed had the power to comfort any soul. As she let the tea steep, the aroma wafted around her, further grounding her in a space of tranquility. Walking over to her mahogany bookshelf, Clara's fingers danced over the spines of various novels, memoirs, and encyclopedias. She was in search of that particular book, a treasure she had kept aside for a moment like this. It was an old leather-bound tome, its pages yellowed with age and its spine creased from the tales it contained. It had been a parting gift from her grandmother, who had whispered to her on her deathbed. "Clara, this book is special. Save it for a night when you truly need an escape, a night filled with magic." Clara had always wondered about the cryptic nature of that message, and tonight felt like that magical night. Settling into her plush, velveteen armchair, she propped up her feet on a matching ottoman and fluffed the cushions behind her back. The large window beside her provided a panoramic view of the city. Far-off buildings twinkled with lights, streets buzzed with the remnants of evening traffic, and the silhouette of trees swayed, painting fleeting shadows on her apartment walls. The first page of the book was inscribed with an elegant handwriting that she recognized as her grandmother's. It read, "To those who believe in the magic of words and the world they can transport you to." Intrigued, Clara delved into the novel. A few paragraphs in, the story began to take shape. It was set in a quaint village named Lumina, where the moon played a vital role in the lives of its inhabitants. It was believed that on certain nights, the moon had the power to bring stories to life, weaving tales from the very fabric of the universe. As she read, the ambience in her room began to match the magic of Lumina. The weather outside seemed to be resonating with her chosen novel. Every gust of wind, every flash of lightning seemed to be in harmony with the world she was slowly becoming a part of. The impending storm's electricity tinged the air, charging the atmosphere with an undeniable energy. Every hair on Clara's arm stood on end, not from fear, but from the sheer exhilaration of the moment. The minutes ticked by unnoticed. The city's sounds faded, replaced by nature's symphony. The wind picked up its pace, whistling through the gaps in the window frame. The first droplets of rain began to pelt the glass pane, each one creating ripples in the story that unfolded in her hands. As the clouds began their tempestuous dance, the lines between Lumina and her reality began to blur. The storm outside no longer felt like a separate entity, but rather a mirror, reflecting the adventures unfolding on the pages. Clara felt a deep connection to the protagonist, Luna, a young girl with raven black hair and striking blue eyes, the very color of a stormy night. Luna's journey, filled with myths, mysteries, and the moon's magic, was only beginning, and Clara was more than ready to accompany her. Engrossed, she barely noticed the hours slipping by. The city, the storm, and the world of Lumina had merged into one, creating an enchanting evening of stories, nature, and memories of her beloved grandmother. Tonight, Clara wasn't just reading a book, she was living it. Every word, every sentence was a step into a realm where magic was real, and stories were more than just tales, they were lifelines to other worlds. And as the storm intensified, so did her journey into the world of Lumina. The moon, occasionally peeking through the clouds, served as a silent guardian, watching over Clara as she navigated through the chapters, eagerly awaiting the adventures that lay ahead. By the time Clara decided to put the book down and stretch her limbs, she felt as though she had been on a journey of a lifetime. The room, with its familiar trinkets and photographs, seemed slightly foreign, as if she was seeing it with fresh eyes. The storm outside had subsided, but the magic of the evening lingered. With the book clutched close to her chest, Clara whispered a silent thank you to her grandmother, feeling her presence stronger than ever. The night was still young, and the world of Lumina awaited. With a contented sigh, Clara took another sip of her now lukewarm tea, ready to dive back into the enchanting world she had just begun to discover. Chapter 2: The First Signs. The backdrop of the city, bathed in the silvery glow of the intermittent moonlight and sporadic flashes of lightning, provided a surreal atmosphere. Clara, engrossed in her book, could feel a palpable electric charge in the air, both from the storm outside and from the unfolding tale of Lumina. The next chapter of the book described a significant event in Lumina, the gathering of shadows. It was a time when the village was said to come alive with tales from the past, present, and future, all converging on this one particular night. As Clara read, the boundaries between the world outside her window and the world within her book seemed to become increasingly permeable. Outside, the first signs of the storm became evident. The winds picked up, swaying the trees in a frantic dance. Leaves and debris spiraled in mini cyclones on the streets below, while the distant sounds of thunder rumbled, growing closer and more menacing. The rhythm of the raindrops became more insistent, each drop hammering against the window pane like impatient fingers drumming on a table. The droplets trailed down the glass, racing one another in their descent, refracting the city lights and creating a shimmering kaleidoscope of colors. Amidst this symphony of nature, a particularly bright flash of lightning illuminated Clara's room, casting sharp shadows on the walls and making the words on her page leap into stark relief. The flash was followed by a resounding crash of thunder, causing Clara to flinch momentarily, pulling her from the world of Lumina. For a fleeting moment, she felt like the protagonist, Luna, was right beside her, sharing the electrifying experience. It was as if the storm was communicating with her, urging her to understand a deeper connection, a secret that the universe wanted her to uncover. Feeling emboldened, Clara continued reading. Luna was preparing for the gathering, an event she had been training for since childhood. The gathering was not just an event, but a rite of passage for the villagers. They believed that on this night, the past spirits would share their wisdom and tales with the present generation, ensuring the continuity of their rich history. As the narrative described the village square buzzing with activity, Clara could almost hear the distant hum of conversations, laughter, and the soft strumming of a lute. She imagined children running around, their laughter echoing, and the elderly sharing tales of old, their voices rich with experience and wisdom. The village was adorned with lanterns, their flames dancing like fiery sprites, casting a warm, golden glow. In the center stood a grand old tree, the Tree of Tales, where the main event would take place. It was said that the tree held the memories of all the villagers, past and present. Luna, being the chosen one for this year's gathering, had the responsibility to communicate with the tree. The young girl was both nervous and excited. Clara could feel Luna's anticipation, her heartbeat sinking with the rhythm of the rain outside. As Luna approached the Tree of Tales, she was instructed to place her hand upon its ancient bark and close her eyes. The tree would then share its tales, which Luna would narrate to the villagers. The young protagonist took a deep breath, and as she touched the tree, a rush of images, sounds, and emotions flooded her senses. Outside Clara's window, the storm mirrored this intensity. The lightning became more frequent, painting the city in alternating shades of darkness and blinding white light. The thunder roared, shaking the very foundation of her building. The elements seemed to be putting up a performance, reflecting the pivotal moment in Luna's life. Clara felt an overwhelming sensation, as if she too was touching the Tree of Tales. Memories from her own past began to surface, her childhood, days spent with her grandmother, the lessons she had learned, and the love she had experienced. It was as if the storm outside was drawing out her own tales, intertwining them with Luna's. The wind howled, and a particularly strong gust blew her window open. Rain sprayed into the room, dampening the pages of the book. Clara rushed to close the window, her heart racing. As she secured it, she took a moment to look out, witnessing the raw power of nature. The city seemed to have transformed. Buildings, streets, and trees were all part of a grand dance orchestrated by the storm. Returning to her chair, she carefully dried the pages of her book and resumed reading. Luna was now narrating the tales to her fellow villagers, her voice clear and confident. With each story, the village of Lumina seemed to glow brighter, as if powered by the collective energy of its inhabitants and their rich history. By the end of the chapter, Luna had successfully completed her rite of passage, and the village erupted in joyous celebration. Fireworks lit up the luminous sky, their colors reflecting the myriad tales that had been shared. Outside, the storm showed signs of abating. The rain became a gentle drizzle, and the interval between lightning and thunder grew longer. The city, having weathered the storm's peak, now basked in its afterglow. Clara leaned back in her chair, taking a moment to process the whirlwind of emotions she had just experienced. The worlds of Lumina and her city, though miles and dimensions apart, felt connected by an invisible thread tonight. And as the boundary between fiction and reality blurred, Clara realized that every storm, both literal and figurative, brought with it a tale worth telling. Chapter 3. The Blur Between Reality and Fiction. As Clara journeyed further into the world of Lumina with Luna, a realization began to dawn upon her. Every page she turned seemed to manifest itself in the world around her. The story's rhythm flowed in tandem with the cadence of the rain, the wind's whispers, and the heartbeat of the city. The lines between Lumina's fantasy and her reality grew thin and porous, and in the next segment, Luna was to embark on a quest to the Mountain of Echoes. According to Lumina legend, this mountain held the answers to any question, but reaching its peak was a feat no one had ever achieved. The path was fraught with trials that tested the very fabric of one's being. Luna, after her triumph at the Gathering of Shadows, felt an inner calling to this challenge. As Clara read about Luna's preparations for her journey, she noticed a peculiar thing. Her own loom began to transform subtly. The soft glow from her lamp seemed to grow brighter, and the shadows it cast started to move, creating intricate patterns on the walls. It was as though her surroundings were responding to Luna's tale. The rustling of leaves outside grew louder, resembling the sound of Lumina villagers murmuring their encouragement and advice to Luna. The wind that earlier howled with fury now whispered secrets, as if guiding Luna and Clara on this new adventure. Luna's first challenge was to cross the Forest of Whispers. It was a mystical place where trees communicated through silent thoughts, and one wrong step could lead an intruder astray forever. As Luna ventured into this forest, Clara could hear faint murmurs filling her room. Words from past conversations, memories long forgotten, and snippets from the book all merged into a melodic hum. The distinction between what she read, what she remembered, and what she heard became almost indistinguishable. The narrative described Luna feeling overwhelmed, much like Clara. The young protagonist decided to sit beneath an ancient oak tree, close her eyes, and focus on her inner voice to guide her. Taking inspiration from Luna, Clara too closed her eyes, allowing herself to get lost in the sensory experience. The murmurs began to make sense, guiding her through her own memories and connecting her deeper with Luna's journey. When she opened her eyes, she found herself not in her cozy room but in the Forest of Whispers, right beside Luna. Together, they navigated the enigmatic terrain, relying on intuition and the guiding whispers of the ancient trees. Each challenge Luna faced in the book was now a shared experience. They crossed shimmering streams, deciphered cryptic messages from the wind, and dance with the shadows. As Luna and Clara approached the edge of the forest, they faced their most daunting challenge yet, the Bridge of Reflection. This ethereal bridge was made of pure, reflective water, suspended in the air. To cross it, one had to confront their deepest fears and insecurities. The reflections showed not one's physical form, but one's soul. Luna hesitated, and Clara felt her own heart rate increase. Holding hands, they stepped onto the bridge together. Images began to surface. Clara saw moments from her past, instances of joy, sorrow, regret, and love. Beside her, Luna grappled with her own inner demons, the weight of her village's expectations, and the fear of the unknown. They comforted and anchored each other. With every step, the bridge revealed layers of their beings, but the shared journey made facing their innermost fears a transformative experience. By the time they reached the end, both felt an unparalleled lightness, as if they had shed lifetimes of baggage. Suddenly, a loud crack of thunder outside jolted Clara back into her room. The transition was so abrupt that for a moment, she felt disoriented. The forest of whispers, the bridge of reflection, and Luna's warm hand in hers, had it all been a figment of her imagination? But as she looked around, she noticed that her room bore subtle imprints of her journey. The pattern of the rain on the window resembled the forest trails, and her own reflection in the glass seemed clearer, more defined. Clara resumed reading, eager to accompany Luna to the Mountain of Echo's peak. But now, there was a shift in her engagement. It wasn't just about reading a story, it was about living it. The storm outside, which initially mirrored the events in Lumina, now seemed to be drawing from Clara's experiences, creating a loop of mutual influence. The narrative described Luna's triumphant arrival at the mountain's summit. She was met by an ethereal figure, the Keeper of Echoes, who congratulated her not just for reaching the peak, but for the inner journey she had undertaken. Luna was granted the wisdom of the mountain, insights and answers she sought. Clara felt an overwhelming sense of pride and connection. Luna's achievements felt like her own. As the chapter drew to a close, with Luna looking out from the mountain's peak at the vast expanse of Lumina below, Clara too felt on top of the world. The storm outside began to wane, and the city sounds gradually seeped back into Clara's consciousness. But there was a newfound serenity in the aftermath. The book, the storm, Luna's world, and hers had all interwoven into a tapestry of experiences that Clara knew she would cherish forever. Chapter 4. Revelations and Reflections. As the storm outside Clara's window slowly subsided, the concluding chapter of Luna's tale in Lumina was poised to unfold. The electric aura in the air, mingled with the pitter-patter of raindrops, set a contemplative tone for the final revelations. Luna, having gained the wisdom of the Mountain of Echoes, was faced with a choice. While she now held the knowledge to elevate Lumina to unparalleled heights, she also understood the balance of power and the responsibility that came with such knowledge. The Keeper of Echoes, a translucent being emanating a soft glow, had told her, "With great wisdom comes the imperative of choice. Will you share this with all, keep it to yourself, or find a middle path?" Clara, so deeply immersed in the narrative, felt the weight of Luna's decision on her own shoulders. As Luna retraced her steps down the mountain, memories of her journey flashed before her eyes. Every trial she overcome, every lesson learned, and every connection made played a significant role in shaping her final decision. The village of Lumina, seen from the mountain's descent, appeared as a mosaic of lights, dreams, and aspirations. The villagers awaited Luna's return with bated breath, their faces reflecting hope and anticipation. The festive atmosphere from the gathering of shadows had been replaced with a more somber, reflective mood. Luna reached the village square where the grand old Tree of Tales stood. Its massive canopy seemed to envelop the entire village, casting protective shadows. The villagers gathered around, their eyes fixed on Luna, eager to hear of her encounters and the wisdom she had acquired. As Luna began to share her experiences, Clara's surroundings once again began to morph in resonance with the story. The gentle breeze wafting through her slightly ajar window carried with it the murmurs and whispers of Lumina's villagers. The soft glow from her lamp began to flicker, casting animated shadows on her walls that danced to Luna's tales. Luna spoke of the forest of whispers, the voices of the ancient trees, and the secrets they held. She recounted the challenge of the bridge of reflection, where she faced her innermost fears, and how crossing it felt like being reborn. But when it came to the wisdom of the Mountain of Echoes, Luna hesitated. She looked deep into the eyes of the villagers and said, "The mountain bestowed upon me insights profound and powerful. But it also taught me that true wisdom lies in understanding when and how to use it." There was a collective gasp, a murmur of confusion. Some villagers were eager to harness the power, while others feared the consequences of possessing such knowledge. A debate ensued, with voices rising in passion and concern. In Clara's room, the play of light and shadow grew more intense. The storm outside might have subsided, but the tempest of emotions and decisions in Lumina raged on. Clara could feel the tension, the weight of collective expectation, and the burden of choice. In a bold move, Luna proposed a solution. Instead of divulging everything, she would share pieces of wisdom periodically, ensuring that the village had time to understand, adapt, and grow with each revelation. This way, the balance would be maintained, and the village could progress without being overwhelmed. This decision was met with a mix of relief and apprehension. But as the days turned into weeks and weeks into months, Lumina began to flourish in ways it had never imagined. The wisdom from the mountain, dispensed in controlled measures, acted as catalysts for growth, innovation, and harmony. Luna's decision had far-reaching consequences. She became a revered figure, not just for her bravery and wisdom, but for her judicious use of power. The Tree of Tales, under whose shade she narrated her experiences, bore a new branch, symbolizing Lumina's new era. As Clara neared the end of the book, she felt a profound connection with Luna and Lumina. The story wasn't just about a fantastical journey, it was a reflection on life, choices, and the delicate balance of power and responsibility. Closing the book, Clara looked around her room. Everything was back to its familiar self, but she felt changed. The storm outside had mirrored the tempestuous journey within the pages of her book and, in many ways, her own life. She realized that, like Luna, everyone is on a journey filled with choices, challenges, and revelations. And while wisdom and knowledge are powerful tools, it's the understanding of when, how, and why to use them that truly makes the difference. The night was drawing to a close. The first hints of dawn began to light up the horizon, casting a soft, golden hue on the city. Clara, with the book clutched close to her heart, walked to the window. The retreating storm clouds, bathed in the early morning light, seemed to promise new beginnings. Feeling a deep sense of gratitude and connection, Clara whispered a thank you to the universe, for the storm, for Luna, for Lumina, and for the magical serenade of reading by the window with lightning.